Back in April, personal finance expert Suze Orman joined us for one of my shows when we were taping the show back at home. Now, what I didn't know at the time when we were talking to Suze was that she was keeping a secret, a big secret from everyone. For nearly 15 years, a tumor was growing on Susie's spine. And despite the symptoms, she couldn't walk, hold a pen, or a fork. She refused to believe something was wrong. This happens all the time. I just talked to her and even saw her, in fact, at the beginning of the year. I saw her when we were in Minneapolis, Minnesota at the Oprah conference there. And I'm seeing Suze stroll around. You don't know what someone is going through when you're on the outside looking in. Well, Suze is bringing us into her home today. She's in the Bahamas to tell us what she learned from all of this. The one and only Suze Orman. It is so good. I mean, you know, we take that for granted when you say it's good to see someone. It is so good to see you, to see
and
you.
I have to say it's so good to be seen. Because the truth of the matter is I was one, like, bumper fender, you know, bumper when somebody just touches you, away from truly being a quadriplegic, all because of my own fear and lack of wanting to deal with the truth, because I was afraid to deal with the truth, even though I was living the truth,
right,
Tamron.
Which is incredible. So let me go back. You were on our show virtually, so I'm watching you from home. You're at home. But I saw you in person, as I said, in January at Oprah's 2020 Vision Tour. You were in one row in front of me. Oprah called you up, and you walked up. And I remember thinking that, I was like, is there a little limp with Suze? But I thought you were navigating through the crowd. What was going on then?
Yeah, I have to tell you this. Oprah originally said that they would just come to me and I would be in the seat and I would be fine. And I was good with that. When she said, come up on stage, my heart just went into my throat. It was like, I can't do that.
How am I going to walk up those stairs? I saw that, Suze. I saw that moment. You were right in front of me. Now that you're sharing everything, I didn't know what was going on. But I saw that moment. And I didn't know what was going on.
And I'm like, all right, Suze Orman, you have got to just do it. And when I saw the number of stairs that I needed to climb up to get on that stage, really, Tamron, I didn't even know what to think. And so I grabbed the right rail and I pulled with every ounce of my strength in my right arm, which didn't have a lot of strength at that point. And I went up and I did it. And I don't know how I did it. And I was equally as afraid to come down the stairs. Mm. And right after that, we left. I don't know if you saw that, because it was like, KT, let's go. Let's just get out of here.
KT is your wife. Now, you just described a painful experience. Even with all of that, you were not ready to face that fear. It wasn't until KT begged you to do something about this pain, to look into it. She saved you.
And the reason is that I had gone to, you know, many doctors, when my leg stopped working a little bit, it would collapse. And one doctor would say, oh, Suze, you just need to strengthen your quadricep. My hand wasn't working because I had carpal tunnel syndrome, because I was answering too many emails on my phone. And I wanted to believe the lies. Just like people with their money, they want to believe the lies that their credit card debt doesn't matter and they still have money to spend because they have credit left on their credit cards.
Yeah.
And so when I finally spoke to one doctor on the phone, because remember, this is COVID now. We don't want to go back to Florida necessarily. And he said, Suze, it could be something with your brain. I need an MRI of your brain, of your upper thoracics. That scared me because I didn't want a brain tumor. I wanted what all those other doctors were telling me, that it was just this, it was just that, wear a brace, it will be fine, exercise more. I was afraid of the truth, yet I knew the truth, Cameron. And I can't explain to you why the powerful Suze Orman can tell everybody, you have got to face the truth when it comes to your money. What is wrong with all of you? Fear is the main internal obstacle to wealth. But guess what? It's also the main internal obstacle to your health as well.
Suze, did doctors say what caused the tumor?
They didn't. It was known as a schwannoma tumor, and one out of a million people get it. Thank God it was not cancerous. But it's a fascinating tumor, and it had grown on between my top thoracics there, C1 and like C6. They had to take out two vertebrae there. And it had cut off 80% of the spinal cord. They didn't even know how I was walking to begin with. There was absolutely hardly any fluid going, and they were like, It all happened so fast, Tamron. I can't even tell you. From the MRI on July 20th into surgery on July 23rd, it was like zam, you know, bam, wow. And there you were. I didn't even have time to think about it.
That's incredible. I know you have been sounding the alarm to people about money, but as you said before the break, listen to your body. Listen to it. React to it. Get the information you need. What's your recovery been like? How are you now?
I'm okay. I'm still not great. Like just to be sitting here, I have to tell you, is difficult for me because there's all this pain still in my neck and I can barely move it. My left hand has been on fire, my whole arm now with all the nerves coming back. And it's intense to say the least.
What is the message you want for folks to get today?
Yeah, you know, for years I've been known for this saying, people first, then money, then things. My new saying is health first, then money, then things. You can have all the money in the world you could ever dream of having, which I do. But without your health, it means absolutely nothing.